For this chart example, we're going to take a look at the Swiss yen cross. And you can see in this four-screen tiled layout, I've got the monthly chart in the top left, the weekly chart in the top right, the daily chart bottom left, and the four-hour chart bottom right. In fact, we're also going to drag in Same thing here. If the next day happens to close higher, we just drag the stop up to 30 pips underneath and do that again and again and again and so on and so on. We would have had a bit of an unlucky break early on where there was a bit of congestion here and the break-even stop would have been triggered. But if that hadn't happened, you can see the process that we're talking about here. We just want to make sure, the longer you're holding on to a trade, the more that can happen in terms of adverse price action. So we just want to make sure that en route to these targets, the market doesn't have the chance to turn against us for too terribly long. Okay, and that's pretty much all there is to it. Again, we're looking for P1 and P2, but since a lot further distance is involved, more pips at stake here, we'll take a slightly more hands-on approach to trade management. But that's all relative. It's at the end of each daily bar close, and that's a little bit different from managing the trade as a swing trade. Okay, so that's just a quick overview of the daily bar entry technique. Let's take a quick pause here and we'll come back and look at this chart and look at the 4-hour and 1-hour entry methods as well.